Alrighty, today we have a fun one. We have a house from the 1950s with an old Cinderblock septic tank. Somebody's been here in the past and they have added a more modern riser and a more modern baffle on the rear of the tank. So this style of tank is no longer acceptable in Maryland, as they're very prone to leaking and structural integrity issues. They're generally made on site by whoever was the utility plumber for that time. Could have been anybody who put it in. So even though most of these were actually permitted and were acceptable back in the day, nowadays they're no longer useful. And whenever you go to sell the property, you have to remove this and put in a proper precast tank. Nowadays, most tanks are going to be precast and tested at the facility prior to being set in the ground. This is to ensure a more uniform structural integrity, as well as to make sure the tank's not leaking. On a traditional septic system, you're going to see something like this, where we have our inlet line, right? We have our clean out, which is going to be those 6-inch ports. And then we're going to have a manhole riser in the middle. Right here is what the manhole riser would look like on a normal tank. In this particular circumstance, it's in the back left corner of the tank itself. The only reason that's going to be the case is probably just because that's where the lid was, or that was probably the easiest place for them to cut and add a new lid to the tank. But back to this. So you're going to have the front lid right here, middle lid right there, and another lid on the back of the tank for all precast tanks. In Maryland nowadays, if you're getting a new system, you're going to be getting a 2-chamber septic system at about 1,500 gallons in total capacity. It'll look just like this, except for there will be an actual concrete wall partition in the middle, and that'll kind of act as 2 tanks in series with one another. And the goal of doing that is to increase the longevity of your absorption system. So in a tank, you're gonna see that the top layer is called scum. It's gonna be all your fats, hairs, oils, greases, etc. And on the bottom, we're gonna have something called sludge. That's gonna be all the human waste, etc., that kind of collects together, falls to the bottom. The liquid in the middle is what we refer to as the effluent. That's gonna be the wastewater that will go off into the drain fields. So the goal of a septic tank is to capture all of the solids and be watertight and allow the liquids to transit on into the next stage. With these cinder block tanks, what you'll see is you'll see that the walls are actually going to be just kind of falling apart. You're gonna see the mortar seams. And you can see here, we got some root intrusion into the tank. So they would usually build these on site by stacking all the blocks together, and then they would put this cement on the inside of the wall. And over time, it just kind of flakes off and falls off the walls. You can see at the bottom that the floor is usually gonna be made of dirt. And so these tanks will almost always leak either through the wall or through the bottom of the tank, just like this. So if you ever own an old home, or if you're looking to purchase an old home, it's a really, really good idea to have somebody who knows what they're looking at come in, take a look at it, see what the composition of the tank is, tell you where everything is, see if everything's working, so that way you know what you're walking into. Again, in the state of Maryland, if you have a cinder block septic tank, you're going to end up needing to basically crush and backfill it and install a precast septic tank for your property. If you guys enjoy content like this, please go ahead, hit the like and follow button. I'll have more information and videos posted daily on the world of well and septic. If you have any questions or comments, please go ahead and leave them below. I try to get back to them as quick as I can. Till next time.